Good morning, everyone. Let us just settle in. And it's good to see you in the house of God this morning. So together, we are going to present ourselves to the Lord. Come, thou Holy Spirit. We are in your presence. Lord, this morning, we ask that you will come among us and take full control. Holy God and Father, we worship you this morning. We honor you and we adore you. We exalt your mighty name, Lord, King of kings and Lord of lords. And we come and humble ourselves in your presence this morning and ask, O God, that you will accept the praises that we offer unto you this morning, because indeed you are God, and you are God all by yourself. There is none before you, O God. This morning I pray and give thanks that you woke us up. We pray and we give thanks, O God, that you took us here safely. And O God, I pray that our worship will be true and acceptable to you. Lord, you do not ask of us any sacrifice, but your praises, O God, because you indwells our praises, and we worship you this morning, and we exalt your mighty name. We praise God for the things that you have given unto us. Lord, many of us have been confronted with very troublesome situations over the past week, but here we are this morning because you kept us. And Father, we thank you, and we honor you, and we exalt your name. Father, we're joining, O God, with heavenly bodies. We're joining with other believers all over this world this morning in praising and worshiping you, Lord. And we say thank you for all your blessings. Thank you for the glorious privileges that you have afforded unto us. Because, Lord, there are many this morning who are not as free as we are to be worshiping out in the public like this, but they have chosen way. They have found ways, O God, to gather and to worship you. We pray for them likewise, Lord, and we pray that your presence will be among them, and that, O God, their hearts and their spirits, O God, will be uplifted, because their assurance is not in this world, but we look forward to a better world, a better life. Oh God, and I pray for those who are suffering this morning, those who are depressed, those, oh God and Father, who do not know where to turn, because Lord God, their finances are so limited that they have not been able, oh God, to pay their bills, to feed their children, oh God, to provide the shelter that they need. But Lord God, this morning we are trusting you that you will open up the windows of heaven and you will pour out your blessings upon them, and that, dear God, their hearts will begin to rejoice. Father, we pray for those who are sick, oh God, who have not received the best of news, oh God, from their doctors and their medical teams, but we thank you that you are the great physician and you are the healer divine. And Father, in you alone we put our trust, we put our faith, we put our confidence, because we know, dear Father, that you have promised in your word never to leave or forsake us, and no matter what it is, dear God, we can hold firm to your unchanging hands. And this morning as we present them, Lord, I prayed that their faith, oh God, will rise up. They will rise up in their faith and believe you, God, and be strengthened, even if not in their bodies, but in their minds and in their spirits, oh God, knowing that we have an unchanging God. This morning I pray for our service, oh God. I pray that as we present ourselves, we present, oh God, the worship team. We present, oh God, the team in the sound booth. We present our Sunday school teachers. We present our ministers. We present, oh God, every single member that will be present, and those not in this physical building, but those at home, oh God and Father, who are listening, those who are driving, those who are at work, but they are listening, oh God, and they need that touch. I pray for that special touch and that special anointing upon everyone, Lord. I pray in the name of Jesus this morning that your Holy Spirit will come among us, and Lord, for that the person will be presenting your word, that, oh God and Father, that word will come through and will find, oh God, place and fertile soil in our hearts, and that those words will produce and, oh God, bring to fruition fruits even in the week ahead of us. May your blessing be upon all your people, oh God, as we give you thanks, as we give you praise, as we exalt your holy name, and we say thanks in advance for all the blessings, oh God, that you will pour out, and the praises, oh God, will come up from our hearts before you. In the name of Jesus, we pray with thanksgiving. Amen.
Today is a very special day here at Milliken, and we praise God for this opportunity to worship. I'm going to ask you, please, to pay close attention to what will be written on the screen, because you're going to join with me as we do the call to worship and as we read together. Oh, come. Let us bow, worship, and bow down. Let us kneel before the Lord, our God and Maker.
Enna api vandana namaskara karamu. Apage devi saas madum mau karuvana Yehova idirihe danin vete sitimu.
Varangal kunindu vananguvom. Namudaiya thevanum padaippalarumana kattarukku munbaga mandiyiduvom.
Today we have service in three different languages, Sinhala, Tamil, and English. And it's because we are celebrating today with the Sri Lankan members of our congregation, because this is their new year. Congregation, can you please stand as we join together in this responsive reading from Psalm 4, and we'll be reading the first 5 verses. Please bear close attention to what is written on the screen so that you will know when to respond. Your responsive time will come either when you see congregation or you might see everyone. I read, "Answer me when I call to you, my righteous God. Give me relief from my distress. Have mercy on me and hear my prayer.
How long will your people turn my glory into shame? How long will you love the delicious and seek false gods?
Samidanan dahemi ayat tamantama toragat bava sitara ganna etumano mage yadumata savan dena seka
ungalai edo onru tunpurthuvadinal neengal koopam kondalum paavam seiyadirungal. படுக்கைக்கு செல்லுகையில் அவற்றை பற்றி சிந்தியுங்கள் அப்போது அமைதி அடைவீர்கள்
Offer the sacrifices of the righteous and trust in the Lord
Swamini api apage assa kanvi uttakara apage kematta aashawan oba veta baradenu apawa piligena obage shuddhaatman karunakata gena Yesu swansege naamen mahimaya kara apagena yanna அப்பே அப்பே தேவியன் வாசிட பிரசன்சா கரமோ
கத்ராஹிய ஆண்டவரே நாங்கள் எங்கள் கண்களையும் காதுகளையும் திறந்து எங்கள் விருப்பங்களையும் உங்களுக்கு சமர்ப்பிக்கிறோம் உம்முடைய பரிசுத்த ஆவியினால் எங்களை ஏற்றுக்கொண்டு இயேசுவின் நாமத்தின் மகிமைக்கு எங்களை வழிநடத்துங்கள் கடவுளை போற்றுவோம்
Let us say together Lord God We open our eyes, ears, and submit our wills and desires to you. Receive us and lead us by your Holy Spirit to the glory of the name of Jesus. Let us praise our God.
Amen.
Amen. Please remain standing.
Good morning, everyone. It's good to see you all this morning. I just want to say a very happy new year to our beautiful team here who is representing representatives from Sri Lanka and in our Sinhalese and Tamil community. And I just wanted to be able to say that I'm so blessed to be able to have them on our team this morning. And we're going to be able to share and worship together. You're going to learn a few things this morning, but ultimately it's for worship to our God. Amen. And we're going to give praise. We're going to count our blessings this morning. So we're going to sing this song together as we worship. Count your blessings. Name them one by one. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we will what?
Rejoice.
We will what?
Rejoice.
We will rejoice and be glad in it. I did tell you you're going to learn some things this morning, right? So this morning, in honor of our Sri Lankan New Year, we are going to be learning two languages today. We're going to be singing in Sinhala, and we're going to be singing in Tamil, and I have my dear friends that are going to be helping us here. Rashnika and Ravesh and Sister Mercy are going to help us to be able to learn that. So we're going to sing "This Is the Day." It's very simple. It's you might get a little tongue-tied for a little bit, but that's okay. We're all learning together, right? But it's all for the glory of God, and I wanted us to be able to worship together, being able to celebrate all of our cultures and together. So let's worship together as we sing, "This is the day that the Lord has made."
We will rejoice and be glad in
going to learn it in Sinhala. So Rashnik and Ruvesh, teach us how to sing it first. Simple enough. We're going to try it together. All right, we're going to sing in Sinhala. 2, 3, 4.
Medavase, medavase, samidun sadu, samidun sadu. Prithivemu, prithivemu, apisamadena, apisamadena.
Sister Mercia, teach us in Tamil. This is your turn. 3, 4.
Indrayana, Indrayana, Katyatanditare, Katyatanditare, Makelevom, Kalikondidevom, Kalikondidare, Katyatanditare, Indrayana, Katyatanditare, Makelevom, Kalikondidevom,
seated. We'll be having our first scripture reading that will be taken from Acts chapter 3, verses 12 to 19.
The first reading is taken from Acts chapter 3, verses 12 to 19. I'll be reading in Tamil. பேதுரு அதை கண்டு ஜனங்களை நோக்கி இஸ்ரவேலரே இதை குறித்து நீங்கள் ஆச்சரியப்படுகிறது என்ன? நாங்கள் எங்கள் சுய சக்தியினாலாவது எங்கள் சுய பக்தியினாலாவது இவனை நடக்க பண்ணினோம் என்று நீங்கள் எங்களை நோக்கி பார்க்கிறது என்ன? ஆபிரகாம், ஈசாக்கு, யாக்கோபு என்பவர்களுடைய தேவனாகிய நம்முடைய பிதாக்களின் தேவன் நம்முடைய பிள்ளைகளாகிய இயேசுவை மகிமைப்படுத்தினார். அவரை நீங்கள் ஒப்பு கொடுத்தீர்கள். பிலாத்து அவனை விடுதலையாக்க தீர்மானித்த போது அவனுக்கு முன்பாக அவரை மறுதளித்தீர்கள். பரிசுத்தமும் நீதியும் உள்ளவரை நீங்கள் மறுதளித்து கொலை பாதகனை உங்களுக்காக விடுதலை பண்ண வேண்டும் என்று கேட்டு ஜீவாதிபதியை கொலை செய்தீர்கள். அவரை தேவன் மரித்தோரிலிருந்து எழுப்பினார். அதற்கு நாங்கள் சாட்சிகளாயிருக்கிறோம். அவருடைய நாமத்தை பற்றும் விசுவாசத்தினால் அவருடைய நாமமே நீங்கள் பார்த்து அறிந்திருக்கிற இவனை பலப்படுத்துகிறது. அவரால் உண்டாகிய விசுவாசம் உங்கள் எல்லாருக்கும் முன்பாக இந்த சர்வாங்க சுகத்தை இவனுக்கு கொடுத்தது. சகோதரரே, நீங்களும் உங்கள் அதிகாரிகளும் அறியாமையினாலே இதை செய்தீர்களென்று அறிந்திருக்கிறேன். கிறிஸ்து பாடுபட வேண்டுமென்று தேவன் தம்முடைய தீர்க்கதரிசிகள் எல்லாருடைய வாக்கிலும் முன்னறிவித்தவைகளை இவ்விதமாய் நிறைவேற்றினார். ஆனபடியினால் கர்த்தருடைய சன்னிதானத்திலிருந்து இளைப்பாறுதலின் காலங்கள் வரும்படிக்கும் முன்னே குறிக்கப்பட்ட இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவை அவர் உங்களிடத்தில் அனுப்பும்படிக்கும். This is the word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord. We're going to continue in worship with singing the song, Down in the Valley where My Savior I Would Go. How many of you have determined in your heart to follow Jesus anywhere He leads you? That is the desire of my heart. I see your hand, Jason. That is the desire of your heart. And we all desire to follow wherever He leads. I know sometimes walking down that road is difficult, but nevertheless, we have determined as believers that when we accepted Christ that we would follow Him, and we, whatever the cost may be, we would choose to do so. So just like we did earlier, we're going to sing in two languages, on the chorus only. So we're going to sing the verses in English, and then we're going to sing verse two, we're going to sing the chorus in Sinhala, and then on the chorus three, we're going to do in Tamil. So we're going to sing together, Down in the Valley.
sung it just now, so I'm going to ask you to stand, because it's one of those songs that if you sit down too long, it will fall away. So we're going to ask you to stand, and we're going to sing just the chorus. I remember when, as a Sunday school boy, when they taught me this song, I loved it. And I'm so happy that we have it this morning. So can you just raise your voices and sing again, one more time? One, two, three, sing.
Follow, I will follow Jesus.
Lord, can you look around at somebody and smile, please? And that is the welcome from Milliken this morning. It is so good to have us all here. And those persons, now what I'm going to ask you to do, please sit, because there's some people that we have to give a big welcome to. Yes, Lance, you can sit because you are accustomed. Now, all those people who are here for the very first time, you need to stand, because we want to welcome you with a very special welcome. And don't be shy, okay? Don't be shy. Come on. If you're here for the very first time, can you please stand? We're going to sing it at the end, but we pray that God will bless you and make you a blessing. May this time that you share with us and we spend in the presence of the Lord be rich and enjoyable. May it be inspiring and empowering. Praise God for bringing us all together this morning. Thank you so much. What else I want to say? Are you happy that you're learning two languages this morning? You see, God has given us to each other, and sometimes because of stuff, we are so, you understand what that means? We are so separated that we fail to benefit from the richness that God has given each one of us. Today, we are changing that script, and we are enjoying the fact that God has given us each other from different places, but it's the same blood of Jesus that makes the difference. If you had, during the course of the week, something very special that happened to you, can you give the Lord a big round of applause? Now, Pastor Eddie, you did not remind me, and I will deal with him in private, but this is the second Sunday of the month, and we did not say a special God bless you to the people who were born last month. So I'm going to ask you, if you happen to have been born in March, can you stand? And I'm going to ask you to do something special, because you were not given your rightful due. Can you come down to the front, because I'm going to pray with you. Come quickly. Praise the Lord. Imagine what we would have missed. Come around. Wow. Can you just bow your knee? This is good. Yes. Find some place to kneel, if you can. Pastor, can you just walk behind each of these individuals and touch them, please? Father, we thank you so much for this amazing privilege that you have given to us to celebrate your gift of life, to celebrate your gift of people, to celebrate your love. We pray, Lord God, that this time as they kneel before you, even though the month has passed, when you have allowed them to come into this world, that they will know, Lord God, that your goodness have not passed, that your goodness continues to flow to them every single moment. And Lord God, may their lives reflect your goodness, your grace, your power, your forgiveness, your provision. Thank you, Lord God, for doing it. For we join our hearts together and we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. And all the people of God say, amen. God bless you all. God bless you all.
We're going to say, make us one. So we invite you to stand and greet one another as we sing this song together.
It is a beautiful spring morning, and it's so good to see everybody in the house this morning. Bringing the announcements. So spring has sprung, and so has the action as it continues here at Milliken. So make sure you do not miss out on all the great things that are happening in the life of the church. And to ensure that we don't miss out, if you are a ministry leader and you have activities, if you have events happening within your ministry, please ensure that you get that information to Pastor Asia or Pastor Eddie prior to Wednesday night at 9 p.m. so that we can make sure it gets announced, so that folks will know what's going on, so that they can participate fully in what is happening around the church. So please do make sure your announcements are in by Wednesday. I want to wish a happy new year, a Sinhala and Tamil New Year to our brothers and sisters in Christ. We are enjoying this fellowship this morning, and thank you so much for what you bring and the richness that you bring to this congregation. So we're so grateful. As you will know, as we continue in the week, this Tuesday, April the 16th, we will have Best Years Fellowship. So for those of you who are living your best life and not going to anybody's workplace as a senior, on Tuesday morning at 10:30, we will be having a special Best Years Fellowship focused on home care. And Infinite Care Services will be presenting that information. So come out for a good time of fellowship, but also important information as we think about the things that we need to consider as we transition through the various stages of our lives. Also want to remind the men of the congregation, men's breakfast is back in action on Saturday, April 27th at 9 a.m. So that's in person here at the church. So come out for a good meal, good fellowship, a good time of worship and the word. So Saturday the 27th at 9 a.m. for the men. Please make sure to make a point to come out and join the men's breakfast. For the ladies, it's our time. I opened up last week. I warned you it was coming. It's a mother-daughter annual tea party. So we are going to be having our tea party on May the 18th. So if you are a mother or a daughter, you qualify. Bring your friends, bring your nieces, nephews, nieces, cousins, no nephews, they can't come. They can go to men's breakfast though, to the tea party. And today we will be starting the ticket sales. Understand, ticket sales mean an exchange of money for goods. So if you brought your money, you will receive a ticket. If you did not bring your money, you will receive some prayer to hope that you remember your money next week, because there will be no holds on tickets. Okay? We want to ensure that we have an organized process. And so if you forgot today, no problem. Put it in your phone, put it in your calendar, put a reminder next week, as we will be exchanging funds for tickets. So we will be starting selling tickets this afternoon after church. So please do, if you remembered to bring your money along this week, feel free to visit the table and grab your tickets, or make sure that you get yours next week, because when the tickets are gone, I'm so sorry. Don't come and say, Desiree, but no, I gave you plenty warning. So we are looking forward to a wonderful time together as ladies on the 18th. We have special guests, we have some entertainment, and we are just going to have a wonderful time as we usually do at our tea party event. We also want to bring an early warning for all of you church members that our local church conference is soon approaching in May, on May 29th at 7 p.m. And maybe not?
No.
It is? And so just put that in your calendars. If that's not something that you've participated in before, you have some time to check in with Pastor Eddie or Pastor Aza as we think about the business that has to happen in the running of the church and the things that need to be in order. So please do pray about that. Have it on your heart as we think about, you know, how we function as a church and as we function within the conference of the Wesleyan Church. Also, just a reminder for those who are participating in the Chinese English Corner, we're going to be taking a little break right now. So if you are interested, we're still open to new students, because the old students aren't that far ahead. So if you want to learn Mandarin, we have been blessed so much by Joan, who has been patient with us and teaching us our Mandarin. And so we're so grateful for her. And we have an opportunity to continue to learn. So if you're interested in that at all and you haven't done it yet, it's not too late. Please reach out to Pastor Eddie or Pastor Aza or Chris and just let somebody know, so that we can make sure that you get the information so that you can join when it starts back. Also, if you are free on Wednesday mornings, we have been blessed with the opportunity to worship and fellowship with the Willowdale Welcome Center. So at 10 o'clock on Wednesday mornings, we have an opportunity to have worship with them at the Willowdale Welcome Center. So if you're free on Wednesday mornings, please do reach out to Pastor Eddie or Pastor Aza and join in that worship opportunity and ministry opportunity as well. Now, there are many more things. I won't bore you with the rest, but do check out the reel as we go. Check out our social media. Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, all the things, as well as our website, to keep abreast of all the things that are going on. And I hope you will make it a point to be a part of these events, because we know that the church doesn't just exist on Sunday mornings, but all the things we do to connect and fellowship with each other throughout all the days. So I hope you take note and have a great week.
Thank you, Desiree, for keeping us up to date. We're going to continue by giving. This is the time that we give our tithes and offerings, and we thank you for how you've given thus far. We are so grateful for your contributions. Keep in mind that, as is our custom, we're going to go down the center aisle, and you can lay your gift as the announcement reel goes on, or you can go online to give your gift at www.millikenchurch.org and then /give. And then once you go to give, you can give by PayPal or you can give by e-transfer. So just letting you know your options. Let's go to the Lord as we bless our offering. Thank you, Lord, for this day that you have given us. This is the day that you have made, and we truly rejoice and are glad. And so, Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to give at this moment. And, Lord, we thank you for your provision, for how you've provided for us throughout the week, and probably for has sustained us through even the most difficult of times. We thank you. And Lord, as we take a portion of what you have given to us, I pray that you'll bless it, Lord, and I pray that it will be used for the furtherance of your kingdom. May we truly be cheerful givers today. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. The song that we're going to sing is called the Hymn for Ceylon. And this song is a special song to bless the land of Sri Lanka. So we're going to sing this together. Jehovah, thou hast promised.
We are so blessed that we're able to have one of our younger members of our church here, and he's no stranger to us. Rivesh is going to come, and he's going to bless us with a song. Children this morning. We have any children in our midst? Really, nobody's here today? Do we have any children here? Come on down. Come to the front for those of you who are here. And our sister Rowanika is going to be sharing with us something special. So come on down.
Good morning. How's everyone? Have you heard of an island called Sri Lanka? You have. This is actually the flag of Sri Lanka, and it's just south of India. It's a small, beautiful island. And today we celebrate the Sinhalese and Tamil New Year. The main communities of Sri Lanka are Sinhalese and Tamil, and we celebrate the New Year. This is, historically, it started with the sun entering the zodiac of Aries, which is falls in April. It's usually celebrated on the 13th and 14th of April. With both communities in the New Year is one of the most important events of the year and brings together families as they practice the traditions. We just wanted to talk a few things about why we do this. During this time, the Sri Lankans, according to the tradition, encouraged to refrain from material pursuits and engage solely in their religious activities or traditional games. There's a lot of games that happen during this time. There's firecrackers, the rabana, which is a drum that fills the streets. It wakes everybody who has slept through the night to signal the dawn of a new beginning. Alut Aurudu Dava, which is called in Sri Lanka. Each household will light the hearth facing the designated direction. Over its flames, they will boil milk in a new pot, allowing it to bubble over into the symbol of prosperity. The traditional New Year dish, kiribat, which you'll get to taste in the gym today. Hopefully you like it, with some sweets as well. And we welcome you to join us in the gym after the service. So although we don't necessarily believe in auspicious times, which is more the Hindu and Buddhist traditions, this is about doing everything at the same time, as one country, as united as one. Especially with a civil war, which we had for over 26 years, both the Sinhala and Tamil communities do together has a larger meaning for all of us. We use, they use flowers quite a bit. This is the national flower of Sri Lanka, which is the blue lotus. And I have some flowers with me today. If you can each take one, just to symbol the new year. Okay, I hope you learned something about the new year and about Sri Lanka and the communities that live in this country. And we encourage you to come and taste our food as well after the service in the gym. Thank you, and God bless you. Yeah, Pastor, should we have a prayer? Yes. Lord, we bless these children and put them in your hands, Lord Jesus, as they learn about your word. And we bless the ceremony and all of the blessings that everybody has put together today as well. And we bless everybody who has touched and participated in this ceremony as well. We ask all in the precious blood of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You can go now.
All right, you can all go to class. Who wants to lead? Somebody. There we go. Thank you, Athiel.
Luke chapter 24, verses 36b to 48. And I will be reading in Sinhala. Devan Vahansege Kiyavima, Luke Visihatara, Tishaye Sita Hatarisata Dakwa. ඔවුන් මෙසේ කතා කරමින් සිටියදී උන්වහන්සේ ඔවුන් මැද සිට නුඹලාට සමාදානය වේවායි ඔවුන්ට කීසේක. නමුත් ඔහු ත්‍රස්තව බයපත්ව ආත්මයක් පෙනුනැයි සිතුවෝය. උන්වහන්සේ ඔවුන්ට කතාකොට නුඹලා කැළඹෙන්නේ මක් නිසාද? නුඹලාගේ සිත්වල ශංකා හටගන්නේ මක් නිසාද? මාගේ අත්පා බලා ඒ මම බව දැනගන්න. මා අතගා බලන්න මක් නිසාද මස්සා ඇට මට තිබෙනවා නුඹලාට පෙනෙන ලෙස ආත්මයකට නැතයි කීසේක. උන්වහන්සේ මෙසේ කියා තමන් අත්පා ඔවුන්ට පෙන්වූසේක. ඔවුන් ප්‍රීතිය නිසා විශ්වාස නොකර පුදුමව සිටියදී උන්වහන්සේ ඔවුන්ට කතාකොට කන්ටි යමක් මෙහි නුඹලා ළඟ තිබියදී ඇසූසේක. ඔවුන් බැදපු මාළු කෑල්ලක් උන්වහන්සේට දුන්නෝය. උන්වහන්සේ රැගෙන ඔවුන් ඉදිරියේ කෑසේක. උන්වහන්සේ ඔවුන්ට කියනසේක්. මාගෙන මෝසෙස්ගේ ව්‍යවස්ථාවේද අනාගත වක්තෘවරුන්ගේ ලියවිලි කියවී ගීතිකාවලදීද ලියන ලද සියල්ල සම්පූර්ණ විය යුතුයයි මා නුඹලා සමග සිටියදීම නුඹලාට කී වචන මෙයයි කීසේක. එවිට උන්වහන්සේ ඔවුන්ට ලියවිලි වැටහගෙන පිණිස ඔවුන්ට සිත් පහදවදා. ඔවුන්ට කියනසේක්. මෙසේ ක්‍රිස්තුස් වහන්සේ වද විඳින්ටත් තුන්වැනිදා මළුන්ගේ නැගිටින්ටත් යෙරුසලමේ පටන් සියලු ජාතීන්ට පසුල් සැවිලිසා පව්කමාවද උන්වහන්සේගේ නාමයෙන් ප්‍රකාශ කරනු ලබන්ට යුතුයයි ලියා තිබේ. උන්බලා මේ දේවල්ට සාක්ෂිකාරයෝය. This is the word of the Lord. Amen.
Can we give the Lord a clap offering for the worship team? When Pastor Asa decided that we were going to sing in three different languages, it sounded ominous. But you've seen this morning how working together makes a huge difference. And we praise God for this. Can we please bow our heads and our hearts as we pray? Not our words, O God. Not our good deeds. Not our best intentions. It is you and you alone that makes the difference. It is you, Lord Jesus Christ, that causes the sun to shine and scatter the darkness. It is you, O Holy Spirit of God, who gives to those who will trust in the Lord and not depend on their own understanding, the knowledge and the wisdom, the strength that is necessary to make it through another day, another challenge, another moment of uncertainty. It is you. Oh, three in one, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, that brings beauty and freshness to life. And so this morning, as we celebrate you, oh God, we pray that you will hide your servant behind the cross of Jesus Christ, and you will teach us from your word, so that this day indeed will be a good day, the beginning of many. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Can I ask you a few questions, please? Thank you for answering. Balance. What is balance? Have you thought about it? Okay, don't answer yet. Balance symbolizes an even distribution of weight, which enables you or me or something to remain upright and steady. That's okay? I know you would have said that. So you have balance, you have stability, you have equilibrium. That's one of those very big words. You have steadiness, you have your footing. I wonder how many people understand the significance of that. I'm going to come to that shortly. Answer me then, what about gravity? Anybody know anything about gravity? No, there are a lot of scientific things. So make it simple. Gravity? It's a what? It's a force that pulls you down and keeps you what? From floating. Is that good enough? Oh, you love that. So with gravity then you can have things like attracting force or downward force or a pull or a weight. But the whole objective is to keep you what again? Keep you, one word, the S word, steady. Okay. Now, answer me, even if it's just with a smile. What about chaos or chaotic? Anybody? No, that is chaotic. But what about chaotic? Anybody know what that means? One word? Confusion. Another word? Maybe a D word? Disorder. Hey, people are awake. So it is when you have complete confusion or a state of utter disorder, chaotic. And so, one last one. What about environment? Anybody? Come on. Pardon? It's the surroundings or the habitat. It's where you live or something exists. So now that you know what the sermon is all about, let's pronounce the blessing so you can go home. As I was sitting there just now before I came, I remembered an instance at work. I think it was last year. And something happened. My head just seemed to have gone off my body. Can you understand that? And when I tried to move, I almost fell. Because something at that moment was not working right. And I was not able to maintain steadiness on my footing. Has anybody in here ever suffered with vertigo? So you understand what I'm talking about. The inability to maintain steadiness, focus, balance. Things just seem to go out of order. It is confusing. But there are situations in life that not only pull the rug from under us, but bring us to the place of feeling that there is totally, absolutely no way that I can make it the next step. The devastation, the fact that the lives seem to be turned upside down, hope completely shattered. I don't know if you're with me yet. Everything seemed to be a total mess because something has happened. Maybe it was the death of a loved one. Whether it was expected because that person was sick, or it was totally unexpected because an accident occurred. And the question is, why bother? What is the sense of going on? Some persons who are at this place have actually committed suicide. And some others have attempted to do the same. Because life is no longer what you thought it would be. You expected maybe that person to be with you until the Lord comes. Or you will go together. Maybe it is that a family that was so loving and kind and together just turn on one another and seem to be eating one another to shreds. And this is the experience that we see in Luke chapter 24. In Luke chapter 24, we see two people walking along a road extremely sad. Their whole world has become a mess because something drastically wrong happened. And as they walk along and they spoke with each other, something happened. Because at this point, all seemed futile, all seemed hopeless. And the stranger comes and asks a simple question. What kind of conversation is this that you have with one another as you walk and are sad? The stranger recognized that they were sad. I know when you get home, you're going to read from verse 13 right through to what we have read this morning. And they said, are you a stranger here? You don't know what is going on? And Jesus said, the stranger said, tell me the things that you're talking about that have so rocked your world. And they said to him, from verse 19, the things concerning Jesus of Nazareth, who was a prophet, mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, and how the chief priests and all rulers delivered him to be condemned to death and crucified him. And listen to this part. But we were hoping that it was he who was going to redeem Israel. Indeed, besides all this, today is the third day since all these things happened. For some of us, it is more than the third day. We are going into maybe the third year, maybe the 31st year, but whatever it was that rocked your world still seemed to have you in its grip. And you know what the problem sometimes is? That too often when we are going through our stuff, we go through it by ourselves. And so the same thing continues to repeat itself over and over, and we seem to sink deeper and deeper, because the more we think of it, the sadder we become, the heavier the weight becomes. And sometimes we decide, okay, let me see if we can bring another person in. But the problem is that that same person that we bring in have the same issues. So we all talk together about the same thing, and it depresses us even more. It is only when we allow this stranger to come into the equation. Someone who would have an outside view to bring a new perspective on what probably was happening. Now, the person who comes in has to be the right stranger. Not somebody who will tell us what we want to hear, but somebody who will tell us what we need to hear and know. And so, Jesus comes into the picture, and he shares with them the new perspective. Let me just read verse 25 and 26, and then when you get home, maybe, or in a quiet place, you can. Jesus said to them, "Oh, foolish ones and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Ought not the Christ to have suffered these things and to enter into his glory?" You see, they could not see why the one that they had hoped to make the difference should have to go through this and put them through it as well. But he was saying, it had to be so that you could be better for it. Are you with me? You can be, and you will be better for it. And then in verse 46, remember that there's still chaos, there's still unsettlement, there's still seeming disorder that is around. And the disciples that Jesus has spoken to so clearly and so lovingly, they were shut up in fear. And Jesus comes in, not by the door, but through the walls, and he comes in among them. And what does it say in verse 46, 47, and 48? Thus it is written, And thus, it is necessary for Christ to suffer and to rise from the dead the third day. And that, this is the part, and that repentance and remission of sin should be preached in his name to all nations, beginning here at Jerusalem. And then he crowns it by saying this, and you are witnesses of these things. He had to suffer. He had to die. He had to rise again and ascend in glory, so that by doing that, the door for every single man, woman, boy, and girl could be open to receive all that God has planned for each one of us. Are you with me? Sure? So why did you have to go through this separation? So that you will know how to trust God in the midst of the storm, in the midst of the chaos, because this God is the one who causes you and I to become grounded and established and empowered and be able to vocalize it. The first parts are for us. When we are going through the storm, God comes and he speaks into our beings a word that causes us, where we were falling from left to right and not able to remain steady on our feet, to become rooted and grounded so that we could become established in him. And then he does something. He sends his spirit to empower us not only to remain standing, but to continue standing, so that when we move, we can tell somebody. That is where the witnessing comes. To tell somebody, it was tough, but the one who is tougher handle my situation. I'm going to say that again. It was tough. I'm going to add something else. And I didn't believe that I could make it. But the one who is tougher told me, you don't need to fight in this battle. I have you. I have it. And using one of the verses of one of my favorite songs, we are more than conquerors through the blood of Jesus Christ. I can make it because Christ goes before me and his spirit goes with me. Maybe you need to tell somebody, I can make it. Sri Lanka or Ceylon went through a period of tremendous displacement. A war, a civil war that tore the people apart and seemed to almost annihilate the whole nation. And something happened to change the hearts of people so that today, what was Ceylon, S-E-L-E-O-N-E, I think that's how we used to spend it in S-E-L, oh, sorry, C-E-L. I didn't remember much from school.
But I remember Ceylon. And I remember them talking about Ceylon. But the fact is that they were able to rise from the ashes of that time of severe pain to be the eagle today. The eagle. The eagle is able to soar above everything else and see from a different perspective. And that's what God did for us. He caused us to rise above what had destroyed so many and attempting to destroy us, caused us to see from a different plane. And that's what the stranger does. He puts us on his wing, so to speak, and causes us to rise. He causes us to rise so that we can become stable, as I said earlier, and established. He causes us to rise in the midst of a world where chaos, sadness, and pain and dehumanization exists. Only yesterday we had another phase in the confusion that this world is experiencing as Iran unleashed its drones on the nation of Israel. More destruction, more pain, more sadness. And it is not yet at its end. It's only the beginning. But even then, God still has it in his control. Balance. Equilibrium, center of gravity, those words, they're all found in Jesus. So that in spite of the chaos in the world, I can remain rooted and grounded. When Jesus came to his frightened disciples and he said, "Do not be afraid." Listen to the words that he said. "It is written." It was written about me. It was necessary for me to die. It was necessary for me to suffer. And I told you, destroy this temple and in 3 days I will rise again. I will raise it up again. Because I told you that no one takes my life from me. I told you that I had the power to lay it down, and I had the power to take it up again. I give it freely. I give it freely because repentance and forgiveness of sin must be preached. Because remember, I told you that my Father so loved you and this whole world that he gave me, so that if you believe in me, you will live. Remember, I told you that he who believes in me, though he dies, he will live. And those who live and believe will never die. Do you remember I said to you that I am the resurrection and the life? So nothing that you will pass through in this life can thwart what I have planned and purposed for you. You're witnesses of all these things. Go now. Tell the world that there is a remedy for the chaos. There's a remedy for the separation between people. There's a remedy for the instability. There's a remedy to correct the wars. There is a remedy. And he says, I am that remedy. Let me just close with this. He was born, and his mother thought that he would be a beautiful child, but when he was born, he was growing up, but he couldn't stand. And they couldn't understand why he couldn't stand. And the more he grew, the more apparent it became that he was crippled. And so, now he is a man. And every day they take him to the temple, place him there, because if they put him at the temple gate, maybe some people will have pity and they will give him a little something. And one day, the disciples of Jesus, those who understood that in the midst of a disappointing, chaotic world, that the remedy was available, they went to the temple. And this man looked at them and asked them for alms. And he looked intently at them because he was expecting something. And the disciples said to him, look at us. We don't have any silver. We don't have any gold. But we have something that you would love. What was that something? It was not necessarily a something, it was someone. He said, I'm going to give you Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up, walk. Are you with me? The man believed. They took him by the hand. And as they took him by the hand, the man realized for the very first time that something was happening. There was tingling in his feet. And he could put his feet flat on the ground where before he could not do it. And like a reflex action, he tore his hand away from theirs and he stood and he started to dance. Because this man who was well over 38 years, for the very first time, he had the remedy for his confusion. He had the remedy for his chaotic life. Jesus had made him completely whole. You are not here by accident, whether you're in this chapel or watching online. Jesus has the remedy for your chaotic situation. He will make you whole. Will you release yourself to him? going to ask the worship team to come. They're going to sing at least one verse of the song, "All to Jesus I Surrender. All to Him I Freely Give." If you are in the place where there's something that is stopping you from experiencing stability and hope and life and joy in this life, no matter how slight it might seem, come. God made it possible for you to be here so that this day could be the beginning of something new. Please, don't stay in your seat. Come. Because this is the beginning of the next phase in our lives. Thank you, Father. Thank you so much. Hallelujah.
I'm going to invite you to stand as we sing this song together.
Thank you so much that as we surrender to you, you fill us with the joy of heaven. We bless you, Lord God, because we know we are leaving this place with you. Even as we surrender the world and its circumstances to you, the threat and the reality of war, murder and pain, gunplay and drug abuse, protests and insurrections, whatever seem, oh God, to be making this world so chaotic. We know, oh God, that you are doing the new thing. So for us here and online, for your children everywhere, we pray, oh God, that you will, by your goodness and your grace, speak your word of peace over every troubled situation, so that your name may be glorified, Lord Jesus Christ, so that the power of your love may be made real, so that harmony may come and life may bloom. Father, in the name of Jesus, take us and use us as your witnesses to tell the world the remedy is here. Jesus, the Christ, makes all things new. So we surrender to you, Lord Jesus. We give our nation, we give our province, we give our peoples, we give the people of the world into your hands. Take us, Lord, and be glorified. Hallelujah. Pastor Eddie, I'm going to ask you, please come and do the benediction. Hallelujah.
The same spirit, in a way of closing, I want you to hear these words coming from the mouth of Jesus to your heart as he prays for us. He says, as he prays for all of us, those that have followed him and those that will follow him later, he says, I have revealed you to those whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours. You gave them to me, and they have obeyed your word. Now they know that everything you have given me comes from you, for I gave them the words you gave me, and they accepted them. They knew with certainty that I came from you, and they believe that you sent me. I pray for them. I'm not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, for they are yours. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine. And glory has come to me through them. I remain in the world no longer, but they are still in the world. And I am coming to you, Holy Father. Protect them by the power of your name, the name you gave me. So that they may be one as we are one. While I was with them, I protected them and kept them safe by that name you gave me. None has been lost except the one doomed to destruction, so that scripture would be fulfilled. I am coming to you now, but I say these things while I am still in the world, so that they may have the full measure of my joy within them. I have given them your word, and the world has hated them, for they are not of the world any more than I am of the world. My prayer is not that you take them out of the world, but that you protect them from the evil one. They are not of the world, even as I am not of it. Sanctify them by the truth. Your word is truth. As you sent me into the world, I have sent them into the world. For them I sanctify myself, that they too
may be truly sanctified. These are the words that Jesus heard as he was preparing to physically part. But also he remembered those that will follow later, and he says, my prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one, Father, just as you are in me and I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one as we are one. I in them and you in me, so that they may be brought to complete unity. Then the world will know, only then the world will know, that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. Father, I want those you have given me to be with me where I am and to see my glory. As we come to the end, I want you to hear those words from Jesus, that in the midst of the chaos that sometimes you might be sitting in, he is having you on his mind. And he says, righteous Father, though the world does not know you, I know you, and they know that you have sent me. I have made you known to them and will continue to make you known, in order that the love you have for me may be in them and that I myself be in them. Lord, teach us to find our center of gravity in this chaotic world. Teach us, as the psalmist said, to number our days. And now we are reminded that everything that we can pray about and think of ultimately belongs to him. And now to him who is able to keep you from stumbling, to him who is able to keep you at your center of gravity, and to present you before his glorious presence without fault and with great joy, to the only God, our Savior, be glory, majesty, power, and authority through Jesus Christ our Lord, before all ages, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Turn to that person and speak this blessing. I feel so much delight in my heart as I look around and I see some friends that I've not seen in some time here, and my heart is just delighted. So we want to express our gratitude that you are here today. How do you say Happy New Year? You say Puthandu Vathkal. Did I say it right? Puthandu Vathkal. Puthandu Vathkal. That is Happy New Year. And you say Nandri. You say thank you. Did I get it right? Puthandu Vathkal. And you say Nandri. Very easy. May the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and forever. Amen and amen. Now go in peace and continue to seek the Lord. We are going to sing. Before you exit, receive this as a conclusion or as a declaration of a blessing to you. Open your heart and your mind as we go in this blessing. Thank you so much. We cannot say thank you enough. God bless you, and may God thank you in his ways, because he knows to thank you better than we can. Bless you.
The Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
In Sinhala.
Swami Nopahata, Asiri
Dismissed.
In a special way, we are going to majestically walk to the gym so we can continue this fellowship or celebration. God bless you all. We love you. Friends online, we unfortunately cannot invite you to the gym, but we love you so dearly. God bless you.